Now let's head over to the House of Representatives in Quezon City, where President Duterte is expected to physically deliver his fifth State of the Nation address later today. RG Cruz is there with the details. Hi, RG.
Hi, Mimi. Good morning. We are now seeing the House of Representatives gearing to open the second regular session of the 18th Congress. We are now getting live pictures from inside the session hall, where, of course, there are only 30 lawmakers and staff who are around, physically present for the opening of the morning session, and they are the ones who are also expected to attend the afternoon session to hear the State of the Nation address, the penultimate State of the Nation address of President Rodrigo Duterte. What's going to happen in the next few minutes? Well, of course, we're going to have the convening of the second regular session beginning with the call to order, followed by the invocation, the national anthem, the remarks of Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano, then a roll call of all members. 30 are physically present in the session hall, including some officials. And then the rest are going to be joining via virtual conferencing. And then this will be followed, once a quorum has been established, the House will proceed to the consideration of several ceremonial resolutions, like, for example, House Resolution 1059, informing the Senate that a quorum being present, the House of Representatives has entered upon the exercise of its function. That will be followed by a House Resolution 1060, which is similarly informing President Duterte that the House has entered upon the exercise of its functions. Then this will be followed by House Concurrent Resolution 10, providing for the Senate and the House to hold a joint session to hear the message of the President of the Philippines. This will be followed by the reading and referral of messages from the Senate, the consideration and adoption of Senate Concurrent Resolution 12, creating a joint committee of the Senate and the House to notify the President that the Congress, now convened for its second regular session of the 18th Congress, is ready to hear his State of the Nation address in a joint session of both houses. Then it will be followed by the appointment of members to the joint committee to notify the President that the Congress is ready to receive its message in joint session. Then there will be a report of that notification committee, and then that will be followed by the adjournment. That is the very simple agenda for today's morning session, the opening session of the second regular session of the 18th Congress on the part of the House of Representatives. And if you're looking at the live pictures that we're getting from the House now, you can already see some of the lawmakers taking their positions on the floor. You can see the layout of the session hall. This is not what we've seen in previous sessions. Of course, this has been the norm since COVID-19 hit the country. Up there in the washroom, we can see Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano waiting for the start of the actual session, which he is expected to preside. Now, in terms of the agenda of the second regular session, which is, of course, this whole following year that will begin today, we will see we are expecting the House to tackle more legislation that will address the COVID-19 pandemic. And, of course, we are also expecting the national budget for next year, which is 2021. And, of course, there are other bills that are expected to be tackled by the House, including the creation of the Department of Water Resources and Services, the creation of the Water Regulatory Commission, and additional benefits for solo parents. The House will also continue deliberations on the creation of the Department of Disaster Resilience. The House will also continue other discussions on other bills that are expected to be needed in the course of the following year as the country grapples with the COVID-19 pandemic. Mimi?
Thank you very much, RG, for that update.